Hi everyone, this is Ari from Komar University of Science and Technology. If you have used older version of Google Classroom or you haven't used it at all, this tutorial is for you. In order to use Google Classroom, you need to log in into your account, then click the Apps button, scroll down until you see the Classroom icon, or alternatively you can type classroom.com. Every previously created classroom will be listed here. If you want to create a new one, you need to click create, type your course's title with semester suffix, section and location. There are three tabs: stream, classwork and people. We will go through them one by one. Every faculty member need to add this email, which is cus.lecturer@komar.edu.iq, as a co-teacher to his or her classes. This is for archiving them at the end of every semester. Second, you can invite your students either one by one or copy-paste students' email from the file that OSAR will provide you after the registration process is done. This is the OSARS file. Filter to your course and section. Then copy all emails. And paste it here. Then click invite. Or second way of adding student is by clicking about. Then share this class code with them. They will be able to join by typing this class code. Or you can go to the setting tab, then you have option to display the code, to copy, to reset, or to disable it. The next tab is classwork, which is the heart of Google Classroom. You do most of the work under this tab. Firstly, you need to create some topics to your class in order to your materials to be organized very nicely. Topics such as homework, quiz, lecture notes, and course syllabus. You can reorder your topics by clicking the three dots and move down or up. Then start uploading materials. Type the title of material and attach a file to it. If you don't choose a topic for your material, it won't be under any newly created topics and it will be on top of the page. You can easily edit the post, then choose the most relevant topics. You can continue adding all lecture notes if you have them ready, or add them weekly. Another feature is ability to set a certain date and time. If you don't want to post them immediately, more importantly, add your course syllabus. The next thing is adding an assignment. You can add an assignment to multiple courses and or subset of student. Try to type very short, meaningful title and try not to use a lengthy title. You can have your assignment explained in the description part. Update the point, add a due date time and choose a topic. You can add a file to the assignment itself, then This shows how many students have or haven't submitted their work so far. You can click the assignment, then read them. After you finish reading them, grade them or add a private comment, which only that student will be able to see it. Once you click return, the student will be able to see his or her result individually and immediately. Next thing under the classwork tab is add Incursion, which is very similar to Google Form but simpler. Every class has an associated folder inside your Google Drive. You can go there directly by clicking on the folder icon. The last thing under the classwork tab is reuse post, which is very useful when you want to post something from other classes that you have created before.